So this is the same Red Hat type of operating system that I have installed in my VMware.
Right.
Okay, you just say this is a CentOS.
Right.
Basically, that CentOS and this Red Hat Enterprise Linux OS are both are same.
Okay.
So the only difference is Red Hat is a commercial and CentOS is a like it is like open source or it is a free license operating system.
Okay.
Okay, so the same features and the same desktop and the same options all are same compared to Red Hat.
Okay.
It is a clone, we can say it is a Red Hat clone.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so I just installed this operating system in my VMware and I just opened it. So now you are able to see the screen, the desktop of this Linux operating system, right? So here we have some like menus and icons and all those things. And I think I have already explained about all these things, right? These are
right, yes.
And the browser and some like the mail reader, send email. It is just like Outlook and it is just like Notepad.
Right. Right.
Volume and the network and Bluetooth and the data and time and the username and all these things. If you want to shut down or restart your computer, then you can go to this system menu. And from here, you can log out your user account or you can shut down or restart the computer like this.
Okay.
And here we have the user screen, user options, user options can be presented here. And so this is a terminal which is used for like performing all the operations in Linux computer. So whatever the, our system administration or network administration tasks are there, all these tasks
are performed
from this command prompt, this terminal. It is called as terminal.
Okay.
See, now we can open this terminal means you can open this terminal from these applications and system tools, the terminal.
Right.
Or other
application ways, system.
Yeah, application system tools, terminal.
Okay.
Or otherwise, you can directly open this on using this right click button of your mouse. You just right click on it and go to open in terminal.
Okay.
So open in terminal, it will directly open your terminal or command prompt. And here, see, you're able to see some prompt here. This is called as prompt.
Okay.
So that prompt contains many informations that I'll explain you. And see here. So in that prompt, the first name, the Venkat, is nothing but the username.
Right.
Who logged into this particular computer will be displayed over there. And at localhost. It's the name of the computer name.
Right.
So this computer is having the name like localhost. And the desktop. Like desktop is the path or present working directory.
So the localhost and desktop, we going to name when we setting the
so the desktop OS? Will not be the desktop will not be changed. The name is common, but the local
It's automatic created. Okay.
Yes, exactly. So see, in our Windows machines, we are in the desktop, right? This is our desktop.
Right.
So in the same way, the Linux machines also contains the user's desktop. So that name is common.
Common. Okay.
Computer name can be changed. Like here, we have the computer name like localhost.
Okay.
So if you want to change the name, that you can change at the time of installation, it will ask you to change. If you don't change then automatically it will take it as a local host.
Right. Okay.
And now you are presented in the desktop directory or desktop folder.
Right.
So desktop is nothing but this desktop. So whatever the icons or the files or folders you are seeing here, that all are presented here also. So this is the command view of that.
Right.
And see, by default, this Linux machines contains number of desktops.
Okay.
Number of desktops. See, this is one desktop. And if you want to switch to another desktop, here we'll have an option. In the bar, it is showing like workspace 1 and workspace 2.
Okay.
So you
the bottom.
You can switch between these two. If you go to the workspace 2, the workspace 2 is completely empty. It is not having anything.
Right.
And the workspace 1 contains our the application or the terminal. Terminal is opened in the workspace 1. It is nothing but
okay. So we can open as much as or the just 2 limited.
No, we can change as many as we want. If you want to go to change that, just go to the preferences and here you can add your number of workspaces. And how many workspaces that you want to see, you want to use.
Right.
And the one more thing is, we have this is completely the command prompt operating system. Mostly the Linux users or the Linux administrator works on CUI only, not in GUI. But our Linux operating systems are providing the GUI utilities also for performing some tasks.
Okay. GUI also.
Yes, GUI. This is all belongs to the GUI.
Okay.
There are a number of applications out there that we can use to perform certain tasks.
Right.
Mostly the administrators won't use them because operating system to operating system or flavor to flavor, these options or the applications may change.
Right.
But the commands will not change. Always, mostly all flavors or all distributions will have the same type of commands. So that's why most of the users or administrators use only commands to perform all the tasks.
Okay.
Okay, so from here we can work on the commands.
Sure.
And before that, before using or before learning the commands, we need to identify the file system of the Linux operating system.
Right.
See, in Windows computer, it is completely different. If you go to Windows computer, so here we have the drives like this, C drive and D drive.
Right.
And whatever the folders here we are seeing, like desktop or pictures, documents, downloads, all these are belongs to any one of the drives in this computer, right?
Right.
For example, this documents is there. So if you open this document actually contains some files and folders. But actually this documents is not a individual folder. It is based on some drive.
Right.
So that maximum that will be the C drive. In the C drive, in the users folder, in the user like Venkat folder, we have a document. So whatever the contents are there here, so it is showing them in this area, which is some short. Right. So these are some quick access tools or quick access folders.
Right.
So whatever the item or whatever the file or whatever the thing is stored in our computer, that will be stored in the drives which are presented in our hardware, like this. In them only, in these drives only, all the files and folders will be stored.
Okay.
No other location is presented here.
Right.
And in the drives, you can store whatever the information that you want. In the E drive or D drive or in the F drive or G drive, H drive, this is a CD or DVD drive. And
right.
The computer is having only two partitions, C and E.
E, right.
And in the C, we have the operating system, and this is the indication of this, the Windows symbol.
Right.
Microsoft logo is the indication of the operating system drive.
Right.
And this is a normal drive, our data stored drive.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this is about our Windows file system. Let us check it out in the Linux file system, in the Linux operating system.
Okay.
Just see here, 1 second. I'll just change the resolution. Okay. So here the computer icon is there. It is just like our my computer in Windows.
Right.
So if you open this, you will find the drives or the devices which are presented in our computer. So this computer is having two DVD drives. So virtual drives only, not the physical ones.
Uh-huh.
And the file system, whatever the file system here it is showing, this is completely a hard disk.
Right.
So in our Windows, we have the hard disk with different partitions like C and D or E like that.
Right.
But in Linux, it is not like that. If you open this file system, it means you are opening the root of this entire Linux file system. So that file system name is identified with the slash symbol.
Okay.
So that slash indicates the everything, the hard disk it is. So every file or folder is stored or presented in this within this slash only.
Okay.
Okay, so if I open this file system, then it is opening this slash, and this slash contains several folders like this here.
Right.
So these are all the folders or files, folders only, which are presented in the slash, means in our computer. Mm-hmm. Like in our Windows, we don't have the drives here, C drive, D drive, E drive, like the type of drives will not be presented here. Here we have folders.
Right.
So here these folders are called as the directories. These folders are called as directories. And this total concept is called as directory structure.
Or directory structure, okay.
Okay, so it contains several folders here, and each folder is having some different, we can say, each folder will store the different type of information here. And here, whatever the folders are presented, all these folders are belongs to the operating system only.
Right.
If you want to create your own partitions also, or your own folders also, you can create over here.
Okay.
So that but I'll show
we
you.
We can change the names, right?
Yes, we cannot change these names because these are the operating system default folders.
Right, right. Okay.
So each and every folder is designed or created for a specific purpose here.
Right, right. Okay.
So let us see some folders, some important folders here. For example, the bin is there, B-I-N. So this is a folder or directory which contains all the available commands for your Linux machine.
Okay.
These are the commands. These are all the command files.
Right.
Which can be run by the normal user and as well as the administrator.
Okay.
So whatever the commands or the binary files are presented in the bin folder, that all can be run by any user.
Okay. Okay, Mr. Venkat. When we open the bin, there's two different types of folders. The one with the symbol, this one symbol here.
So these indicate the exe files. And these are the normal, like the text files and the zip files are like this.
Okay, okay.
So these are all the exe files, the executable files, like softwares.
Right, right. So what indicates this symbol? This symbol here, this symbol?
This symbol, the diamond symbol. Yeah. So this is an indication symbol of exe in Linux.
Oh, okay.
In Windows, it will show you like something different now, like this is one icon.
Right.
And we'll have the different icons like this, right?
Right, right.
Some exe files and folders are having the indications like this.
Right, right.
So in the same way that Linux is having the different format like this, that each and every executable file will be displayed like...
No, some of the files are plain and some of the files have this symbol here. You see the arrow?
Arrow indicates a shortcut.
Shortcuts, okay.
Normally in Windows also, see here, for the Google Chrome, there is one arrow symbol, right?
Right, yeah.
Actually, that file is not belongs to this location. This is, that actual file was stored in somewhere else in the directory, but that can be opened from here directly. Shortcut. Yes, these are like shortcuts.
All right, okay.
So this symbol indicates a shortcut.
Shortcut, okay.
So like this, these are all the basic commands which can be run by normal user and as well as the administrators. And there is another folder called SBIN.
SBIN, yes.
So SBIN is nothing but like we can say super bin, super user bin.
Okay.
So this is a bin folder which contains the same type of commands, but these type of commands can be run by only administrator.
Okay.
So these are all administrator commands, means our commands.
Right.
We'll use normal commands and as well as the administrator commands, but normal users can use only normal commands.
Right.
And in the same way, the boot is another directory is there.
Right.
So boot directory contains some files which are used for starting your operating system.
Okay.
These are the very, very important files which are used to start our computer.
Right.
And this is a kernel loader, VM Linux,
right?
Which loads your operating system kernel at the time of starting your computer.
Okay.
And here you can find the version number that is 2.6.32-431. That is the version right. number of your kernel.
Right.
In some other operating systems, like in Ubuntu or some other operating systems, you may find this file with a different version.
Okay.
That is completely depend upon our installed version.
Right.
So the boot is a folder which contains the bootable files for starting our OS.
Okay.
And dev, D-E-V. So this dev folder contains the device files.
Device files.
In the sense, see, our computer contains so many devices, hardware components, we can say, like RAM, hard disk, CD drives, and the ports and connectors, USBs, and many more. There are many more ports or many more components will be presented in each and every computer, right? That each and every component here in Linux is identified with a file, as a file.
Right.
So that all files are presented in this DEV folder.
DEV is okay.
So this DEV device files, these are all. Number right. of files will be presented for everyone. Like for DVD, we have a one file. And for hard disks, there is a file. And for the floppy drives and the everything. Whatever
right.
seeing in our computer, that every device contains a file here.
Right.
Using these files only, that Linux operating system is going to operate or manage or control the hardware components. And if you want to communicate with any of the other hardware component here.
Okay. So if we want to find any files from here, we can go to device and find it, right?
No, these are not the files. These are the device files.
Right, right. Device. Okay.
These are not the normal files.
Okay. So this is device files. All right.
These files are all or belongs to the hardware components.
All right. Okay. Now I understand. Yes.
Okay. So the device folder. In the same way, etc is another folder.
Right.
So etc folder is a folder which contains all the configuration files for your Linux.
Right.
It contains several folders and files which are very useful at the time of configuring your computer. Any type of configuration, every configuration will start with the etc folder only.
Okay.
Because it contains every configuration. Like if you want to change your computer name, here you need to take a file and you need to change the name of the computer. If you want to add an IP address, from here only you can change it. If you want to do any server service configuration or anything, that all can be done from here, etc folder only.
Right. Okay.
So one of the very, very important folders.
Mm-hmm.
And we have the home folder in the same way. Home folder is a folder which contains, it is just like a home folder for the users.
Right.
Home folders means, see, in Windows computers, if you go to the operating system drive, you will find one folder called users, right?
Right.
So the users folder contains the users information. The public is different. The Venkat is the logged on username. So this computer is logged on with the Venkat user.
Right.
So if you go to that Venkat user folder, you will find so many things here. These are all belongs to that Venkat folder only, Venkat user only.
Right.
Like that, every user will get a folder over here in the users folder.
Right. Uh-huh.
In Windows, it is.
Right.
So in the same way, the users folder, whatever the work of the user folder is, that the same work can be performed here by the home folder.
Home, okay.
So it contains all user directories like this. Now this computer is having one user account, Venkat.
Right.
So that Venkat user contains several things like desktop items are there, documents are there, downloads are there, just like our Windows.
Right.
In Venkat folder, desktop is there, documents is there, downloads are there, like this, whatever the folders are that are personal to the user, that all documents or personal folders will be presented here in the home folder in Linux.
Home, okay.
Okay, so see here, whatever the, like for example, desktop is there. If you go to the desktop, so whatever the items here you are seeing, that all will be presented in our desktop also, like this. See,
right.
Zoom credentials file is there. Linux file is there. If you create any file or folder, see there, new folder is created.
Right.
And one test folder, it was renamed as a test.
Test, okay.
So in the same way, So in Linux also we have the folder structure here like this.
Okay.
So these are belongs to the Venkat user. If your Linux machine is having any other user account, then you will find another folder here.
Right.
So that folder contains the different the menus or different personal documents of that particular user.
Right.
So this folder can be directly opened by using this option.
Uh-huh.
Right. So this is our home folder, and the home folder contains only the user's home directories, not the administrator's one.
Okay.
Administrator's one is separately stored in Linux. In Windows, all will be presented at the same location, but in Linux, administrator home folder will be stored in the different location, and the all other users' home folders will be stored in the home folder.
Right. Okay.
So here the administrator name is root.
Root. Okay.
So that root for that root user, there is a special home folder here.
Right.
This home folder is not created under home.
Right. Do separate. Okay.
Separate. And some library files which are needed for running our operating system. Library yeah. files, and these are 32-bit version and these are 64-bit versions. And lost plus found one folder is there. It is just a null folder. It doesn't contain anything.
Right.
So, but it will be useful for our Linux computers that I'll explain you later what is the use of this lost plus found. And see some media folder is there. The media folder initially it was empty.
This empty. Right.
When you insert any CD or pen drive, that device will be displayed over here.
Okay.
And this MNT folder is at present it is empty. It doesn't contain anything. But you can create some folders here and you can use like in your own way.
Okay.
I'll give you some examples in our classes what is the exact use of this MNT and folders. And
right.
some optional folders are there, optional files and folders. This OPT folder and the running processes information will be stored here in proc folder. These are all the
right.
processes. And root is the root user's home folder, and sbin the super user commands, and sc linux. It is called as sc linux. It is, and these are the some booleans or we can say some policies for setting up the security in our computer. So in our troubleshooting or in our security concepts, we'll discuss about this folder and sc linux, and some
services
information, system files, temporary files. And one more important one is a USR.
USR.
Yes. So in Windows, we have a one folder name called program files.
Right.
So this is a folder which contains the applications that are installed in our computer.
Right.
Okay. So in the same way that USR folder here in Linux contains the installed applications in our Linux machine.
Okay.
So in our Linux machine, whatever the applications are installed, that installed applications information will be stored in?
In user, okay.
In USR folder.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So like this, some variable files are there. Like this, the different folders and files are presented here. See,
okay.
Every partition in Linux also will be displayed as a folder only.
Right, okay.
So we cannot describe or we cannot see the differences here between the files or sorry, the folders and the partitions. So it may be a partition, the boot one.
Right, the icon is going to be same, right?
Yeah, the icon is same for everyone, every folder here. And
right.
this may be a folder or this may be a partition that we cannot identify that. But at the time of our partition classes, I will explain you how we can identify them or how we can check them.
Okay.
Okay, so everything here, it will be presented here, like in a folder.
Right.
Whatever the things you want to do, that from here only you can perform. You can create your own folders and you can do your tasks.
Right.
Now, I said already this that we are presented in the desktop.
Right.
You want to check. Where is or what is your present working directly that you can check easily by using a command called pwd.
Pwd.
Yes, present working directory.
Present working directory. Okay.
So it displays the present working directory in our computer. So you are working in home, Venkat, and desktop folder.
Right.
Means the desktop folder is presented over there. You can see here. If you go to this computer, home means slash, in slash home folder is there. In the home folder, Venkat folder is there, and in that the desktop folder is there. Now you are here in the command. Right. From here only you need to, means from here you are performing the tasks.
Okay.
So in this desktop that is presented in the Venkat folder and home folder slash. Means Venkat folder, home folder slash.
Right.
So the pwd is a command used for checking the present working directory like this. And the command is the date, used for displaying the date.
Right.
And clear is a command used for clearing your screen. And now we'll create some files and folders here.
Okay.
So let us start with the folder. If you want to create a folder, how we can create a folder? See, for creating the folder, the command is mkdir.
Mkdir, yes.
And space, and here you need to give the directory name.
Right.
So whatever the name that you want to give for your new directory, that name you have to mention here. For example, here I'm giving the name like test.
Right.
See, that folder is created. You can check it here also.
Right, right.
And now, if you want to check whether that folder is created or not, how we can check in the command prompt? So you got my point, right? So after clearing the screen, if you want to know whether that folder is presented or not, or whether that folder is created or not, then how do you check that? So that we can check with ls command by listing all files and folders available in the present working directory. The command is ls.
Okay, listing ls, okay.
Exactly. So if you say ls, that whatever the folders or files are presented here, it will displace you here.
That okay. Ls.
So by seeing it only, we can identify that the folders normally are presented in the color like this, and all files are presented in the black color.
Okay.
Okay, so now we created the folder.
But it's going to be presented as a text, right? The text letters.
Yes, test is a folder name here.
Right.
And if you want to enter into that particular folder.
Right.
So how we can enter is, see, pwd is the present working directory. Now we are working in the desktop. And I want to enter into that particular folder, test folder.
Right.
So how can I enter into that folder is that for that we need to use this command cd.
Okay.
So cd is a command to enter into that particular directory. Cd means change directory.
Okay.
Cd space the test. And one thing you should remember that Linux is a case sensitive operating system.
Right.
So you must use the correct case for identifying the commands or the names of the folders and files.
Right, right. If we want to find some kind of case, like we don't know exactly the word, so where can I look for it? Like,
yes, for example, you don't know in which case the test file name or the folder name is presented. You just list it out first.
Right.
And all of the Linux commands are in lower case only.
Right.
All of the Linux commands are in lower case only. So in the commands case, you don't have to worry. All are presented in the lower case.
Right.
The file names and the folder names, at the time of creating them, we may give the capital letters over there.
Right.
So for them, you have to list it out first. And in the list, from the list, you can identify that which type of characters are presented in that name. So then you can use those characters to enter into or to open that particular thing.
Right.
So now the test is a folder and I want to enter into that folder. So So cd is a command here,
right?
Change directory, and now I'm entering into that particular directory.
Test. Okay.
So you just give cd space test, and now you are in test.
Okay.
Isn't it? See, now here you are presented in the test folder.
Test folder. Okay. Right.
So if you want to check that out, you just use pwd command, then you can find it out. See, the previously the pwd command gave the output till desktop only.
Right.
Now it is giving the test folder also.
Right.
Means now you are presented in the test folder.
And okay.
If you want to come out from this.
Right.
From the test folder, then you just say cd dot dot.
Dot dot. Okay.
Cd dot dot will come back from a single directory.
Okay.
If you say cd dot dot again, then it will come out from the desktop folder.
Okay.
If you say cd dot dot command again, it will come out from the another one. Like this, the folders can we can come back to the previous folders using this cd dot dot command.
Okay.
So mkdir is a command to create the directory, and cd is a command to enter into the directory.
Right.
Cd dot dot is a command to come back from a directory. And ls is the command used for listing.
Listing, okay.
So in the same way, remove this directory, if you want to remove this.
Right.
So I have created a directory already. The test is the name of the directory. Now I don't want that directory. I want to delete it.
Right.
So how can I delete that? You just check it out, see. For example, see, now here I am presented in the home directory, right?
Right.
So in the home directory, the test folder is not there.
Right.
Where the test folder is presented?
It's after desktop test folder, right?
After desktop only we have the test folder, right? So for removing or for doing the modifications to that particular folder, you need to enter into that folder first.
Right.
It means if you want to manage test folder, then you need to enter into the desktop folder.
Right.
From the desktop folder only you can manage the test folder. And from home folder or Venkat folder, you can manage desktop.
Right.
From home folder, you can manage Venkat.
Right.
So like in that way. So now I'm entering into that folder, Venkat. And here also the test folder is not presented. So I need to go to the desktop. And here I can find the test folder, and now I want to remove this. Rmdir space test.
Okay.
So it will remove that folder, and you just check it out by using the same ls command. Now we don't have any files or folders out there.
Okay.
That folder is deleted.
Completely, okay.
That folder is completely deleted.
Okay.
Okay, so in this way we can create the folders, and as well as we can remove the folder.
Right.
Enter into the folder. So now I'll show you the creation of files. Okay. So for creation of files, there are a number of commands. So in them, the touch is the one command, cat is another command. VI editor is one command, and gedit is another command.
Right.
Like that, lot of commands are there here to create a file. See, now I'm going to create a file using touch command.
Okay.
See, ls, if you say ls, now we don't have any files or folders here.
Right.
So now I'm going to create a file. See. Touch space sample. Sample is the name of the file.
Okay.
Now it is created. See, here in Linux, no commands will give the success message. Okay.
So how you find it whether it's success or not?
Yes. If there is no error, means it is success.
Okay.
If you got any problem with that command, then it will display the error for sure.
So let's find out how it's going to be look like error.
Yes, see. So I used some command like TOUSH.
Right.
But the command is not presented. So it means, so there is an error means the command is not executed.
Right. Okay.
So in that way.
Uh-huh.
So now let us check it out. You just say ls here for finding the files and folders presented in that particular directory.
Right.
See, we have only sample file. We don't have test folder now. The test folder is already deleted.
Removed. Yeah. Right.
So the sample file is created, right?
Right.
You can check it out by using this ls command.
Uh-huh.
And now I want to create the same file or the different file using the different command. Ls command will create an empty file. So it didn't ask anything about the information, right?
Right.
That file doesn't, now it didn't contain any information. It's a empty one.
Right.
So if you use a touch command, then you can create only the empty files.
Right.
If you want to create the file with some information, then you can go with the second command called cat.
Cat, okay.
Cat, this one. Cat, single greater than is enough, the new file name.
Okay.
And after pressing that enter, you need to enter the data here.
Okay.
And after completing that information typing, just press Control D to save that file.
Right.
Now let's check it out. Use the ls commands, the same command. Now you'll find two files here. New file name is the one file and the sample is in another file.
Right.
And now, if you want to see the content of that file.
Right.
So using the cat command, same cat command, we can view the contents of that file. For example, see, cat sample. Sample file doesn't contain any information because we have created it as an empty one.
Right.
But cat new file name, if you go to this one, you will find some information here.
Yes.
This is only the information presented in that particular file. We have created that file with that information, right?
Right. So it's whatever information it appears on the screen?
Yes. Whatever the information is there, that information will be displayed on the screen.
It's a full information or it's just short?
Full information it means basically.
Okay.
Okay. So now the file creation is completed. Now file, we have checked it out also. Now we'll use another command for creating the file.
Right.
So the touch and cat commands are the basic commands.
Right.
And we have another command called VA editor.
VA editor, okay.
So VA editor is a powerful editor for creating and modifying the files.
Okay.
So for that we need to use a command called VI.
VI, okay.
VI and the file name.
Okay. So we don't need to write the editor, right?
Yes.
Okay.
And here, see, after VI command, whatever the name you are giving,
right,
that will be treated as a name of the file.
Okay.
Sorry. So if that file is already existed, then it opens that file for modifying that content.
Right. Okay.
If that file name was not found in that location, then it creates the new one.
Right. Okay.
For example, see, I want to create one more file here in the same location with the name new.
Right.
Actually, that file name is not presented there. Only two files are there, one sample and another one is a new file name.
Right.
If I say VI space new, then with the name new, one file is going to be created.
Right.
And the VI command, especially the main advantage of the VI command over cat and touch commands are, it opens the editor for adding and modifying the contents of that file.
Right.
So using this editor, you can manage it. Like you can type the information.
Right.